practice. I know you guys put the pads on for the first time Monday. Just your assessment of how you think it's gone so far.
Yeah, I would think it's been really good. I think the competition has been really good. I think we've had some big plays. Defense has some turnovers. We've had some good runs. We've had some that were stuffed. Like, I feel like it's been a good competition so far. It's been enjoyable.
Is it hard to evaluate you guys as a whole?
No. I think that we've played pretty well so far. I think even though the pads aren't on, it's full speed. Like, we all know that. Whether we're in spiders, whether we're without pads, like, O-line and D-line is going. And I think guys have gotten better even in this short amount of time before this.
Eric, it seems like y'all are running.
Would you mind standing behind the podium?
Oh, my bad.
So we can hear you. No, it's okay.
Seems like y'all are running, at least stuff we were able to see a lot of play action.
Yeah.
Does that help y'all as an offensive line just to mix a lot of that in? And if so, like, why?
Yeah, play action is my pride and joy. The more the better. Just because it gives you an opportunity to be aggressive, even when you're passing the ball. And, you know, it opens up windows in the run game. Like, if they can't tell if it's a run or a pass, then you get people playing slow on the defensive side of the ball, and that leads to big plays.
How would you describe where Nick Saldivari is right now and maybe his strengths from the way you see it?
Mm-hmm. I mean, the one thing I can say about Nick is he busted over the offseason. I mean, he was injured. Had a surgery, had to come back from that, and he put in the freaking work over the offseason. I would say transformed his body, and big, stout, athletic, and I think that he can be a really good ball player for us for a long time. I'm proud of him, and I'm happy for him.
How much have you seen your role as, of course, the leader, the communicator of the offensive line increase with so many more young faces around you?
Was that a question? Statement?
Both.
Okay, yes. Yeah, no. I mean, I've said it a couple times. Before Lucas Patrick got here, I was the oldest guy in the room, which is crazy. I'm in year six. So I feel like I have the role of leader, but I also, with so many young guys, I need to kind of be their friend a little bit as well, because it's hard to coach somebody up, discipline somebody, if they don't feel like they can come and talk to you as a person and as a man. So that's something that I've been learning. Yeah, and we have a lot of young guys, so I'm excited for how these guys are going to grow and develop throughout camp and then throughout the season.
How have you seen Trevor Penning really, you know, adapt to continue to grow and his new role now on the right side?
Yeah, I would say that his confidence has grown a ton, and I feel like as an offensive lineman, that is the biggest key to success. If you have confidence, you can play. You know, it was a hard situation last year, but this year I really think that this can change the trajectory of his career. If he comes out and play the way that I know he can play.
You see a change in him?
I'm sorry.
You see a change in him? You just said, like, you see,
yes, I see
something different in his mindset or attitude or something?
I can see the confidence in him. And I think it's just as simple as that. Like, he's not afraid of making a mistake, which I feel like that's how he spent a decent amount of last year.
And with Tali on the left side, you know, how is he fully grasped in the offense? How is he adapted to the NFL level in practice?
I will say this, as long as I've been here, he is the best rookie offensive lineman that I've seen. Just as far as his mental, his physical, and I think Tali is a freaking dog. Like, I'm a fan already, but don't put that anywhere because he can't know that. I got to talk him down a little bit.
Tell him mute Twitters.
Yeah, I'm telling him to delete it.
It's on live stream.
Okay.
is kind of, you know, one of the leaders or the leader of the offensive line room, you, Caesar, like, what role do you guys play in keeping Trevor's mind right and making sure the confidence doesn't go the wrong way or anything like that?
Yeah, I think we just have to keep building them up. Like I said, last year, his rookie year, like, that was tough. Like, I think if that was any of us, that would be a tough thing to kind of have happen and go through. So I think building them up, and not disciplining, but correcting them, even when he does make a mistake, but in a matter that is still elevating him.
What's the art of that? Like,
you know, it's like, damn, Trev, you just got your ass kicked, but I know that you can block him. So come out this next time and do it.
Yeah.
So.
First of all, can you tell that he's technically learning left tackle, or does it seem kind of natural?
Tali?
Yeah.
Guy's a freaking natural. I truly believe that he could play all four. He can't play center. he could play all four positions on the line and be a dog. Like, I think he's going to be that good of a football player.
What does it do to just have someone that, like, that necessarily have to worry about a rookie that can come in and play, especially since you guys have three new spots on the line.
Is it real? Damn, it is three. No, I think it's huge because I think, truthfully, I think he's going to – I don't want to build him up too much, and I don't want to, you know, project what I'm feeling on him to everybody else. I think it's going to be a lockdown. Like I said, I'm a fan. That's all I can say about him.
I don't want to build him up too much, but I'm going to build him up.
I can't help it. I'm a fan. And I think – what's that? Yeah, he's way better than I was as a rookie.
But I'm saying, like, you know what it takes to start as a rookie. Like, you've done it before. It's not, like, crazy, right? Like, some guys can do it.
Some guys can do it. It's hard. I think it's hard to not start as a rookie, but excel as a rookie. I think there's a difference between just being a guy out there and being a guy out there. And I think he's going to be a guy out there.
Eric, anytime that we talk about the new offensive system, there's always sort of the elements of the game. You talk about play action, motion, things like that. But one thing that always comes up with players is the word fun, that they're actually having fun in the system.
Mm-hmm.
Can you express a little bit about how important that is and how that actually does play a role?
Yeah. I don't really know how to expound upon that much, but just saying that it is fun. The ability to compete, the ability to know that the big play is coming. And just knowing that each coach out there is instilling so much confidence in you to go out there and execute is fun.
And how important is, I mean, it feels like fun is such a thing that we never talk about in football
yeah.
as being like a part of, but how important is it to fun to be a part of
it. Yeah, yeah. You know, I feel like when football is fun, it's easy. When it feels like a business, it's hard. And like there's going to be hard days. Like that's just the reality of the game. But when you're having fun playing, like truly having fun playing, it makes it so much easier. And I think that you can sense that with the entire offense out there.
I know the wideouts got to block a little bit more. Have any of them?
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. And I love it. I love it.
Have they come to you for any tips?
They haven't come to me for any tips because, you know, I don't really be out there blocking those little skinny people. But they do have to block more, and I love it. I truly do. It's an emphasis in every meeting.
What have you noticed with Jordan Mims?
Young Mims. Mimsy. I'm a Mims fan. I feel like he's a guy that not a lot of people know about. Just because we picked him up last year. I don't remember. It might have been week two, week three. But even throughout all of last year and seeing him on the P-Squad and seeing him go against our defense, I was like, this kid can go. And I think throughout this camp, it's just, you can just see that even more. Like, he can go.
What stands out to you about John Benton's approach?
JB, same word you used earlier, fun. Like, yes, he corrects us. Yes, he ensures that we are doing everything correctly and we are executing, but he's fun. Like, the meetings are fun, practice is fun, and he instills so much confidence in each and every one of us to go out there and ball. And that's, I appreciate that.
Yeah,